have gathered here for a function which has never been celebrated before in DDSP, for a program which has never been celebrated before. We had planned last year also, but somehow we were not able to manage this. So today, 22nd December 2012, by then Prime Minister Mr. Manmohan Singh, it was announced that this day, 22nd December, will be celebrated as the National Mathematics Day as a mark of respect to the great Indian mathematician Srinivas Ramanujan, who was born in South India. His genius and extraordinary brilliance in number theory and pattern of numbers brought the focus of the entire world towards India. The subject we are talking about is mathematics. The subject having most number of hitters, the subject having most number of failures, as well as the most number of students getting out of scores as well. The subject in which we are made to assume anything, right from buying 64 watermelons, I think nobody did ever in life, buying 64 watermelons at a single time, walking 100 kilometers, which I think we never did, but still we assume in mathematics. We are celebrating the subject which always tells us to find the value of x, which we never gave. It always tells us to find x while we don't even have a single x. It suggests us to replace x. It tells us that if John has 3 apples, he lost one, find the mass of the sun. It tells us that these two things, despite having a lot of things in common, but they can never meet each other. Yes, I'm talking about parallel lines. Maths tells us that you can do all types of operations despite being non-doctors. Maths tells us, maths gives marks to steps despite we don't do a single dance step. Despite all this, we are celebrating the subject which always teaches us that every problem has a solution. We are celebrating a subject which was and is with us for the longest period of time, right from our pre-primary to our diploma to graduation to post-graduation. Subjects came and went, but maths was there and maths is still there. We are celebrating the subject, believe it or not, because of which unknowingly our mind developed the most, because of which our imaginative power increased, because of which we think and act logically. We are celebrating the subject which tells us that to be number one, you must be all first. So, to speak on this, the birth anniversary of Srinivas Ramanujan, I have with us Master Atharva Dingore from first year mechanical K. He will talk about the life of Srinivas Ramanujan.
The Romans never found maths interesting because X was always 10.
Greetings to one and all, present here, respected principal sir, all my respected teachers, and all my dear friends. Today we all have gathered here on the occasion of National Mathematics Day. In India, 22nd December, the birth anniversary of Srinivasan Ramanujan is celebrated as the National Mathematics Day, which sir told that it was given by government of India to mark his respect. And so Ramanujan was born on 22nd December 1887, and he lived in the British rule. He was a citizen from the Erode city in Tamil Nadu district, and his father was a clerk in a sari shop, and his mother was a housewife. He never liked schools, and schools are very important in Indian culture, but though he didn't like, and he never went to schools. And though he didn't attend the schools, he passed his SSC examination in that time with best scores in the history. And then he never studied mathematics from the beginning, but he developed his own mathematics. it in mathematics. He couldn't pass his bachelor's degree in arts because he was poor at other subjects. But even though he didn't give up and started his independent research in mathematics, which was recognized by the whole world, and then many of the great mathematicians of the world tried to work with him, and many of them got that opportunity. So finally, he was a deeply religious man and credited all his mathematical works to God. He said, "An equation for me has no meaning unless it expresses a thought of God." So, my dear friends, I want to tell you that his life was full of inspirations, and no matter what circumstances be there, but a person can achieve if he wants to achieve. And as our brother says, we should never be dependent on our teachers. We should do our self-study, and we can excel.
This was Mr. Atharva Pingole. Now once again, on this occasion of National Mathematics Day, I welcome you all. Many of the staffs are not here. Actually, they are not here because they are busy with their timetables. So, to welcome our principal sir, Palve ma'am, and the Jagtap ma'am, Swapnil Patil sir, I request our maths HOD, maths subject in charge, Prashant Ahiri sir, to welcome them all with a flower.
Writing our question papers in numbers, But then we realized that yes, mathematics is a part of our curriculum, but not as a special subject, but as a integral or combined subject, it's another subject. Now, if we take as subjects, especially mechanical, so we are getting maths in every, right from FMM, TOM and everything, we get mathematics. So this is what mathematics apna teacher kabhi nahi chhodega. Mathematics is with us, but it is different. Like when mathematics is the part of our life, the life was like this, and now it is like that. Because when we think about in the maths point of view, mathematics is really easy to score, but you don't have mathematics as a subject. So score ultimately drops. So mathematics, as it is said, that it is queen of all subjects, and a kingdom is incomplete without a queen. So how can we curriculum without mathematics? So this is what my experience was about mathematics. And without
my views on mathematics before third semester 3 and after semester 3 are somewhat similar, but I would like to say that mathematics will be with you if especially if you want to pursue a higher education like degree or master's or PhD. Mathematics will, we can assume that semester 4, 5 and 6 will be just a temporary break from mathematics. After that, in engineering, irrespective of branch, you will have mathematics, either in application form or indirect form. If you want to pursue mathematics masters or you want to pursue PhD in that area, then without mathematical theories, it's not possible. If, right from mechanical, electronics, then computers, every branch has application of we can say complex mathematics. Like in computer engineering, if you want to break an encryption, then you will have to apply mathematical theories. Then in a mechanical point of view, if you want to find the stresses or to find the breaking point of a component, you will have to use mathematics. And then we have finite element analysis, and for civil we have structural analysis. All these theories have not been derived by engineers, they have been derived by mathematicians. So the means I would like to make a point that we think that mathematics will be for us for these three semesters only. It's not that. Semester 4, 5 and 6 will be just a break. Break means a small break, that mathematics will not be there. But after you go into engineering, then if you have an interest in mathematics, after engineering, masters, PhDs, and then without mathematics, you can't move ahead. You can't go ahead in your career.
That was very inspiring from Prasad and Arvind. Now we have two more associate professors from our degree college. They also are math teachers, so I want to welcome them all. Welcome, ma'am. And I would request Dr. Patil sir to felicitate Sarika Sari ma'am and Megha Patil ma'am. I'm going to show you a video. So I'll request the dignitaries to please come forward and see.